I'm expecting revival again. Amen. And greet the ones that's next to you. Amen. Tell them it's good to be in church with them. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. It's good to be back in the house of the Lord tonight. And we started off with this song, Revival Night. And Brother Daniel came in and preached about the joy of the Lord is our strength. And how many of you are ready to rejoice tonight? How many of you feel like you've gotten refreshing through the revival? Maybe even got a touch, got healed. You know, God is good. He's still the same tonight as He has been last night, the night before. He's still the same God, and He's still able to touch tonight. If you're burdened down, need a refreshing or a healing, I believe that God is able, that He can do those things. Give Him a good old hand clap of praise. Let Him know you're in the house tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm so thankful for His grace tonight, His mercy, His love. You know, we each have a story in this house tonight. But there's not one here that can't say God ain't been good to you.
That's right.
He's been good to each and every one of us. And, you know, I tend to think He's been the best to me because I know where I've been and where I've walked and the things He's brought me through when I didn't think I would make it. The times of wanting to throw in the towel, giving up and laying it down. But you know what? There ain't nothing back yonder that you can go back to that's better than what you're going to. And, you know, I thank God that He's a good God and He's a God that we can serve and we can worship Him tonight in spirit and in truth tonight because He's a good Father. And, you know, let's just get our minds on Him and know that if you got a need tonight, He's in the house and He can meet the need. This is one of my favorite songs because I know He's a way maker. I've seen Him do miracles. He's my promise keeper, and He's that light in the darkness. He won't leave you alone, even though you may feel like you're in a tunnel of darkness, but He's the light at the very end of it, and He'll see you on through.
My God, that is who you are.
miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are.
Yes, yes, he is.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are here, healing every heart. I worship you. Of you. You are here, turning lives around. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, mending every heart. I worship you. I worship you. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Yes, God. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are.
Yes, he is. Thank you, Jesus.
When you begin to think about those words you're singing.
That's right.
When you, this is not a song.
Right.
You get it in your spirit and you begin to think about it.
Promise keeper.
How good God is. how he's made a way when there seemeth not to be.
That's right.
When you needed a miracle, he performed it. He's never left us without a promise that he hasn't kept. And he's our light in the darkness. And, you know, I just think about being in the darkness. I don't like the dark. I like the light to be on, a night light. But I know now that I've been born again and saved that when I'm in the dark, I'm not alone anymore.
That's right.
When I'm walking through the dark tunnel or the dark places, I got one that's walking by my side that said he would never leave me nor forsake me, no matter where I had to go. He would go with me all the way to the end. And you know, when I think about this song, I just love this song so much because it means so much to me. And you can't just sing a song, I know Charity knows what I'm talking about, unless it means something to you. But this song, and I feel it in my spirit tonight, somebody's here. And you're going through a dark tunnel.
All right.
You're going through this dark place in your life. But God didn't allow you to get to that dark place and not bring you on through the dark place. He wants you to, as I've been told before, tie that knot and hang on and go on through it with Jesus. Because you see, when they were thrown into the fiery furnace, three was thrown in, but they looked in and there was the fourth man in the fire, honey. And when they threw Daniel in the lion's den, God shut the lion's mouth. And if he can do that for them, he can do that for you and I tonight. He can bring us on through no matter what we're going through. We just got to learn to keep our joy because our joy is our strength. And see, the enemy wants our joy because if he gets our joy, then he's got our strength and he's got us. But you see, it takes faith to have the joy because you're going to have the joy when you don't. You're going to have joy when you don't feel like having joy. You know, your joy comes from knowing who God is and what God can do and how he's brought you through. See, I gave a lesson about looking back at your history, what God did for you back then. Remember the things that he did before. Remember what he brought you through. He's not going to let you down and not bring you on through again. I tell you what, it's a war, church. We're in a spiritual warfare with the enemy. He's trying to take out the church. He's trying to take out Christians. But we gotta get steadfast and unmovable and stand up and fight back with the word of God and just stand on the word that God is our. He said he would fight our very battle.
Right.
We don't have to lift a hand. There's a story in the Bible about this armies. I think it was about three armies that was coming against Jehoshaphat. But Jehoshaphat knew where to go. He knew who he needed to call on.
Right.
Even though it would look bad, it looked like all was against him. But you see what happened? He told Jehoshaphat, stand still. Don't say a word. Sometimes we speak when we don't need to speak. Sometimes we just need to be quiet and let God fight the battle. You see, Jehoshaphat obeyed the Lord. And guess what happened? The enemies trampled and killed each other. That's what God will do. He'll take your enemies and they'll destroy one another. If we'll learn to be quiet.
Yes.
Jehoshaphat knew where to go.
Be still.
He knew who would fight his battles. And he's still the same God today.
You're right.
He said he'd fight our battles to let him. That's for somebody tonight. You've been fighting a battle of your life. But that God said tonight, let me fight your battle.
Let me fight your battle.
He wants to fight your battle. But the only way you can let God fight your battle is you to give up your battle and let God take over.
Right.
And when God takes over, you're going to get the victory over it quicker than when you're trying to fight the battle. I've been there and tried to fight them battles on my own. Wore myself out. Up and down, I mean, agitated, aggravated, just disgusted, busted. And God gave me a vision. And I love, every time I think about this vision, I just begin to laugh because God gave me a vision of me in a corner over there fighting. I mean, I was just fighting away. I couldn't see who I was fighting. I guess that was the devil, but I was fighting. And God spoke to me. He said, you want me to fight that battle or are you going to fight it?
Wear yourself out.
Boy, did that speak to me. I thought, thank you, Jesus. No, Lord, you're going to fight it. I don't want to fight the battle because it wears me out to fight the battle. I can't do nothing about it no way.
That's right.
But God has all power and glory. There's nothing he can't. He defeated the devil. He went down and took the king, the death, hell, the grave away from Satan. He has no power over the children of God. Only what we allow to give him. That's what he can take. Only what we allow to give him. So we begin to start to say, Satan, get behind thee in the name of Jesus.
Right.
He has to flee. We don't have to take on those thoughts and fight that battle. Devil, God's got this battle. So you just take your tormenting spirit and you go back to the pit of hell where you belong, because you're no longer going to torment me any longer. That's what we need to tell the devil. That's for somebody tonight. Praise the Lord. Give the Lord a big old hand clap of praise.
Jesus. Give the Lord another hand clap. Amen. Praise the Lord. So good, amen, to know that you're in the house of the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. And you feel the Spirit of God in here already. Amen. And I'll tell you, amen, we're going to have a good time tonight. Amen. Anybody, Patty, you got a song tonight?
I didn't bring that.
Okay. All right. Well, we're going to turn Brother Cap loose.
I bet you Sister Charity's got something.
Sister Charity got something?
I got you, didn't I, girl? Huh?
You going to escort me out with your umbrella?
Yep. I escorted you in, so that's the least you can do. Let her sing one, brother.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, while she goes, go ahead, Oak. Come on up.
By the way, I want the church to know tonight I'm preaching on Jehoshaphat being in battle. So rejoice in the presence of the Lord tonight. Be encouraged, guys. Good God.
Hang my word.
Although I didn't practice today, which I generally do like to practice before I get up here. And
I didn't either.
You didn't rehearse your sermon.
No.
But I am thankful that God allows me to stand and worship Him. And there is nothing like the presence of Jehovah. This is an old one, but a good one. So if you know this one, please feel free to sing with me.
Amen.
Living out of situations that tug on all day long, I struggle for the answers that I need.
Yes.
Then I come into His presence, all my questions become clear, and for the sacred in the presence.
Yes, come on, worship. What a God.
Yes. place to find the answers in the hour of distress. So there is never any reason for you to give up in despair. Just look away and breathe His name. He will show.
Coincidence, luck, or chance. George, can you turn me down just a tad? Just a tad.
Where you at? I can't.
I've got something I want to say before I even get started tonight.
Okay, I got it.
Sandra, I want to say something to you tonight before I go any further, and I want to make it very clear to you that I'm not saying this because do I feel nor have I ever felt superior over you. But I want to tell you tonight that you have grown so much over the years. And when I look at you, I see a warrior. You are a handful.